Good morning.
He wants to show you his dump truck. We're starting out the morning in the play corner. This is normally what we do when we wake up for the first 20 or 30 minutes. Doing silly goose. It's been a while since you vlogged, huh? Just been mama lately. But lately when we've been out and about, I've been getting so many questions on how I keep William entertained, mainly because people like to comment that he is a busy guy. He is a busy bee, and I'm well aware of that. So I figured I would just take you guys along with us today, kind of show you the activities we do and how I keep him entertained throughout the day. One of the main things, I'll just touch on it briefly because I've talked about it many a times, is a toy rotation. He really focuses on each toy much, much longer when he has a limited amount to choose from. Lately, we have been starting our days in the play corner together for the first like 20 or 30 minutes when we can, get some quality time in, get some good play time in, and then I'll let him play independently when I like slip away and go make breakfast. Okay, you're gonna do the spoons. Okay, and there's a bowl. So we had our breakfast and now we are cleaning up. I don't always do this, but when I can, I try and have him help me do chores or whatever I need to get done. Yes, it's a little messier, takes a little longer, but he seems to enjoy it. And then he's learning that he's gonna have to help with chores, as he just spilled some water on the floor. It teaches him that he has to help with chores as he gets older. And we're playing with bubbles and water, and we talk about hot and cold, and I try and teach him colors and different things as we go along. Okay, here you go, buddy. He's like, Mom, turn the water on. We normally have an outing, whether it is an errand, the park, or story time, almost every single day. And then on days like today, when we don't, we make sure we go for a big, long walk. And I usually let William pick between his stroller, his little car, and his wagon. Today, he has obviously picked his wagon, and he's loving it. But while we're on the walk, we chat about whatever we see, whether it is the garbage truck, mail truck, we collect sticks. We just chat about our surroundings and hang out. Oh, you hear an airplane? Say, do you see it? Where is it? There it is. We're just going to finish up our walk here, and then not sure what we're gonna get into when we get home. We don't normally have this hour or two to fill because we're normally out doing something. I might actually grab a piece of tape. I've seen all over Instagram, people are just taking one single piece of tape, making it a tightrope or using it as a road for toy cars or lining up toys like a little parade. So we might see if we can have fun with some tape. It doesn't take a lot to entertain them. You just have to be a little creative. we finished up on our walk, which the big thing on the walk today was the mail truck. We saw him probably 3 times. So that was the big excitement for today's walk. But then once we got home, we did that little tape activity I was talking about. And he's definitely too little to understand it, you know, as a tightrope, but he did like to use it as a road for his trucks. So that was a win, and I'll keep that in the back of my mind for a day that, you know, we need something a little extra, you know, mom's not that creative that day. And then we actually spent a good deal of time in the backyard playing with his little slide and with a ball and his little golf clubs he got for Christmas. That honestly is my default, going outside. If you're bored with playing, if they seem bored with playing, honestly, go outside. You can do anything under the sun. You can collect leaves and have a ball. And I'm sure you guys have seen it on Instagram lately, but we are actually doing the 1,000 hours outside challenge this year. So the goal is to spend 1,000 hours outside, just kind of promoting like a slower lifestyle and more quality time with your kids. So that's what we're doing. I think we're at like 30 hours, which isn't too bad considering we were sick last week and I started it a couple days into January. So I'm proud of us for that. But we honestly spend so much time outside, I just have never clocked it. So should be interesting. Then we had lunch and I got him down for a nap. Now I am using my handy dandy laminator. Guys, let me show you this thing. I think it was probably what, $30, maybe $35. I got it for Christmas. This was the number one thing that I wanted for Christmas because there's just so many fun things you can do with it. And I've already used it so much. So I'll show you guys what I am doing with it. Let me just finish this cut so I don't forget where I'm at. So the first little activity that I have made, you guys are probably like, what in the world is this? I went ahead and printed out some different trucks. So we have a dump truck, semi-truck, pickup truck, tractor, just different trucks that William is into, and then laminated them and then put a little bit of magnetic tape on the back. I originally was thinking we would just stick them to the fridge, the dishwasher, you know, stuff like that. But I saw somewhere, I can't remember where, someone was using a cookie sheet. So I just picked one up last time I was at the Dollar Tree so he doesn't get into mine and I'm looking for mine. So for $1.25, we have a little cookie sheet to use. And because he loves trucks, he'll just be happy with doing this, you know, talking about them. But we can also learn colors. We can, you know, find the wheel or the bucket or, you know, the cab or the window, whatever. We can also match them to his books if we want to read books. Just, it's just a fun little activity. And if he likes it, then I will make other themes. That's the first thing I did during his nap. And then I also, this isn't with my laminator, but the other day we went to Hobby Lobby and on the clearance rack, there was some tulle and I just cut them up in little squares. Nothing fancy, okay? And we're going to dance with them. It's also fun to put them in the air and watch them fall because they fall kind of slowly. These are literally, I think I sent $1.50 and that was for a yard of the green and a yard of the yellow. So I'm gonna find other ways to use these too. They were just on super clearance. I went and was trying to find, you know, a set of colorful scarves made for kids. And I don't remember how much they were, but I just remember thinking, I'm not paying that price. It would be cool to have all the different colors, but you know, this is gonna work. This is totally gonna work. He is gonna have fun with this. He loves it at story time. So we'll probably have a dance party later. Honestly, other than going outside, a dance party is also my backup plan if I'm at a loss of how to entertain him. put on something I know he likes and dancing is always a favorite. I also might cut up some more of these and find an old tissue box or something I can kind of slit in, you know, so we can reach out and just keep pulling out little tissues. So that could be another fun thing. I can't remember if I mentioned it, but he's currently taking a nap. When he wakes up, we usually read a million books. Lately, he has been very cuddly after waking up from his nap. I don't really know why he's been groggy and grumpy, but he has been. So we just kind of hang out, read some books, let him wake up a minute, and then we go into playing. That looks different every single day. That could be playing in his play corner. That could be a certain activity I've set up. We could go back outside. You know, it just really depends on the day and what we haven't done already in the morning. Today we will obviously have a dance party with these, play with our little truck activity. And then after, you know, a little bit of playtime, obviously if I have chores or something to do, then he'll either help me or I'll try and get him something separately to do next to where I'm working. But then after, you know, time goes by and dad is almost coming home, lately I've been giving him some screen time. So screen time is so hard because sometimes we do really good at limiting screen time and he only gets a little bit every day. And then other times, like when we were sick, he had way too much screen time. So that was last week. We were just so sick. No one was feeling good and he had just too much. So we're back on the limited screen time bandwagon. So what's been really working the past couple days is what you've seen, you know, today in this vlog already. And then as it nears time for dad to get home, about 20, maybe 30 minutes beforehand, when I want to tidy up from the day and just get dinner either prepped or even started cooking, depending on what it is, then I give him some screen time. But what I'm excited about, and the whole reason we're chatting about this right now, is because I have essentially made him a little TV guide with my laminator. So let me get this all together. Let's see. So once again, I just printed out everything that he likes to watch at the moment, or everything that we will allow him to watch. Ooh, forgot to trim this one up. We just try and find stuff that's not too overstimulating and hopefully something he can learn some new stuff by watching. So what we have is Super Simple Songs. He loves music. Blippi, definitely learning some cool stuff with Blippi. Miss Rachel, you all probably know Miss Rachel. He's kind of phasing out of this, but he did ask for Miss Rachel the other day. Ask as in, I showed him some of these and he picked which one he wanted. Obviously, I don't want to show him all of these. That's overwhelming, but I normally pick 3 or 4 and then he can pick what he wants. So super simple, Blippi, Miss Rachel, Hudson's Playground, which is essentially this dad and his kids crushing things with tractors. So that's been fun lately. Those are his main shows that he likes to watch. And then you have Little Learning Bookworms, which is a new one. And then a picture of William, because he likes to watch some of my vlogs where he plays, like our Christmas vlogs, he loves. And then the rest of these are more background noise when he is playing with something but has really been asking for the TV and I'm like, fine. Or maybe he'll pick one of these when he's actually sitting down and watching the TV. I have done this when they're all printed out on one sheet and he actually picked the garbage truck multiple times and watched a garbage truck compilation. Literally just them pulling people's houses, getting the cans and moving on to a new house. But the repetition actually is really good for them. They really can fully understand what's happening. There's different color garbage trucks. Sometimes the machine picks up the garbage truck. Sometimes there's a guy who puts it in the truck. Sometimes there's one guy, sometimes there's 2 or 3. So he really is learning, even though it seems really monotonous and boring to us. So his options for that type of stuff is garbage trucks, parades. This one around Christmas time, we were watching Christmas parades, but also Disney parades. He's really been liking skateboarding because dad has been skateboarding and he giggles when dad does flips. We have trains because he's a train guy. Well, trucks, but trains are second, I would say. Airplanes, always running around now like this. Well, his arms are back. Running around like an airplane. He likes to watch them ever since we went to that air show. Monster trucks, this is a brand new one, but he's been into them. I don't know, not my thing, but if he likes them, whatever. And then fire trucks, which one just went by, and I was happy it didn't wake him up from his nap, but sad that we missed it. So I will probably eventually, I was gonna do it today, but I don't know, I was gonna hole punch and then put them all on like a little carabiner, if I can say that word, carabiner, so we can kind of flip through, but I think he's just too little for that. I think instead I need to pick 3 or 4, put them in front of him. He can point to what he wants. I do want to make sure that I am saying the word, so saying blippy, blippy. I don't want this to be a cop out of him pointing and not using his words in the future. But I thought this was something fun because if we're limiting screen time, he should be watching what he wants to watch. I don't know. Maybe that's spoiling him or I don't know, but I think it's a fun thing. I guess we'll see how it goes today. Garbage truck, dump truck, garbage truck. And look, I'm gonna show you. Put it on. Look, which one is that? Fire truck. Yeah, wee, wee. That's like Dada's truck. Fire truck, pickup truck. Garbage truck. There's the tractor. Good job. Put it on. Good job, you did it! Yay! All right, little man's all set up with his snack. Question is, do we want to watch Little Learning Bookworms, Hudson's Playground, Super Simple, or Blippi? Blippi, okay, Blippi it is. All right, little man is in the other room watching Blippi. Shocker, he picked Blippi. but he'll be in there while I kind of tidy up from the day and start dinner until Dad gets home, so about 20-ish minutes normally. When Dad gets home, he'll kind of take over, play with him until dinner time. You know, have their guide time since they don't get it, you know, all day long. And then dinner, bath, then we play as a family normally. In his room, read tons of books, normally a dance party. And then we settle in for bed. Oh, the scars and the magna activity, both just on fire. Both amazing. Amazing things that we will be doing quite often, and I'll be making more of those little laminate magnet things, maybe some animals, I don't know. But if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe because I share content like this pretty often. It's not easy to keep your toddler entertained all of the time. Some days I feel inspired and do lots of stuff. Some days I feel boring and I'm like, let's go outside and play ball again because mom's tired and mom doesn't want to do a lot. So don't feel bad if you have days like that. I do too. But hopefully this video gave you some good ideas. And you can see more ideas over on Instagram too. I post like my mom life personal stuff, I would say, on my personal Instagram. And then over on Little Learning Bookworms, there's more play ideas, kind of what you saw today. So yeah, I will see you guys all next time with another video. Bye.